everyone for a nice introduction. Ladies and gentlemen, thanks for the invitation to participate here today on such a beautiful occasion. And congratulations to the Norwegian University, IMO Center, and the Baltic State Technical University for 25 years of successful cooperation. Probably the most successful and long-lasting cooperation between Norway and Russia in recent years. So, congratulations to Trudel and to Gerdina. I have worked many years in the Norwegian-Russian cooperation in the oil and gas business. I spent 5 years in Oslo working on the giant Shotman project in the Far East. Unfortunately, it was not possible to make that a viable project, so today I would like to present another concept for oil transportation in the Barents Sea. So that is the first introduction you see there. It is a joint oil transportation system that we call Arctic terminal and transportation. There is nothing technological challenges in this. It is a question of making this more commercial concept, which is a joint solution for all the oil producers in the Barents Sea. What I'm going to cover is what is the APT. I gave you a short introduction to that. What are really the advantages of the APT concept? And how can the APT concept ensure low transportation costs? And by that, better profitability for all the oil companies producing in the Barents Sea. What is the best alternative for the oil companies today? And my response to that, that is the best one. I would also like to mention that APT is a project rooted in northern Norway. And the two companies behind the project is shipyard in transit and market protection. And these two companies have in the past organized transshipment of Russian oil in Southwest York, just outside of this world. Successful operation for 10 years. And that's really the idea of doing the same more permanent organization of the transshipment. This will, of course, be extensive benefits. So what is the situation now? Is there a possibility to cooperate with the other companies to establish a third-party service provider? So what is the situation in the Barents Sea today? There is no new infrastructure. There is no new infrastructure for oil transportation. We see high costs in the industry, and the industry needs to get those costs down. The oil industry must be more cost effective, and that is of course vital in today's low oil price environment. And what are we facing? Tough economic conditions, icy, poor visibility, coldness, darkness, lots of environmental conditions. We need secure regularity of operations. That's quite important for the securing of the cash flow for your companies. For example, We have one gas field in production and study and one oil field. But I think now we can see this is the start of an era of oil development in the environment. We can see that now there is increasing from the line. Stavros is planning an FID next year for Petersburg. And Dean, as what we call that full time, is working on extensive development and will be probably starting with FID in 2019. And the fourth partner is the Austrian operating company, which is planning the development of the missing team. These fields are coming pretty close in time, which means we have good possibilities to work with these volumes as part of this concept. The production profiles that we can see based on this is Goliath first, then Petersburg Green, then Alta Ukhta, then Missing, and then we have also given an example of an unknown field, hopefully coming up in the third round. This will yield the healthy production of 500,000 barrels of oil per day, which is more than sufficient to make this most viable project. The decision dates, that means when are the different phases of this development taking place. From the long 10 years period here, where you are planning, developing, and starting production. And you can see Casper and other Ukhta are very vital in dealing with that production profile. So the concept that we are proposing for the oil companies is then the combination of crude oil care treatment to a terminal that lightness, and then using dedicated specialized shuttle tankers to bring the oil from the storage tanks on board the floating installations to lightness and operating that on a continuous basis. That is really a floating and flexible pipeline by these tankers. And it will be given open access the companies, and we did that for more discoveries to make in the future. This is an excellent showing the position of lightness as the focal point for the terminal, and then the various fields that will be connected. The light, Casper, Alta, and Misting, and you can see that the sailing distances are fairly short, 10 to 16 numbers. And even if you get them further degrees, the sailing distances will be more like the same. So this is an optimal point between the fields and the market, which is not by this, the market is common. So this is the thing to collect all the oil in the area. So a little sketch of the Arctic terminal. This is phase one, with one jetty, one special batch of tanker, and three tanks. And that is sufficient for Casper. When Alta Ukhta comes on stream, maybe a couple of years later, we will then have two jetties and perhaps the large three tanks with another three tanks. So six tanks altogether can take, let's say, 500,000 barrels of oil per day. We have sufficient space to enlarge this to 1 million barrels of oil per day. That is the dream scenario, and I don't think we can say trust it can happen, but we have a possibility. The annual costs, we have compared what is the annual cost for the oil companies, comparing selecting direct shuttling from the fields to the market in Rotterdam, compared to using ATG, which is the transportation to the terminal, operation of the terminal, and then the super tankers bring the oil from outside the terminal to the market in Rotterdam. And you can see there is a break even there, roughly at 200,000. Above that, the ATG system is outperforming the shuttle and directly. And that is our main argument. This is good for the companies. It is cost saving. And it's improving its viability as more women travel safe than below. Compared to the shuttle tankers, we can save oil companies for never tried before on oil.